what production expenditure and production expenditure in bossing is so much millions, and also it can be detected by authorities, by government agencies and authorities. So because in bossing equipment is what difficult to hide, very difficult to hide in production line, so can be easily checked. Indelibly marked, meaning it cannot be easily erased. One swipe, okay. So, indication of pig. Maker's logo, name. So those are some of the items. All such markings shall be done at the factory by the manufacturer. So it is not what proper if you see a delivery truck that stop somewhere and then what attaching a label at the roadside. So these are to be done inside the factory. Those are illegal actions, no? Field marking shall not be acceptable. So I repeat, all of the markings or the products, plumbing products, valves, pump, pipings, okay, those are to be marked in the factory, not on any other location or in the field. The next standard listed or referred to in this chapter covered material conforms to the code when used in accordance with limitation imposed in this or other chapters. It's very important to know therefore this listing, no? So I just summarized. Design and materials for special conditions or materials that provided for in this code shall be used only by special permission of administrative authority. What do you mean by administrative authority? If your equipment used for plumbing, for example, there are indication of quality control. Quality control, there is an organization who specifies that this product passed some testing. So quality control. Not ANSI, not UL, not the popular organization. And you check that it is not listed in this code. The manufacturer is listed in the code. The standard is not listed in the code. What will you do? The owner or the engineer, the planner, would like to use that material. What will you do? You can ask for special permit. You can ask for a special permit from the what? UBOC. From the office of building official. You can apply for a special permit, bring the sample to the engineer's office, then apply for permission to use that material. Okay? That is how it is done. That is what we mean by administrative authority. Okay? Meaning office of building official. Section 14.02, meaning the second section of the chapter, iron pipe size. Okay, what do you mean by iron pipe size? Iron, section 2, iron pipe size. Okay, take note of that acronym. It is very common in the plumbing system, this acronym written on every pipe. Iron pipe size. Iron, steel, brass, and copper pipe shall be iron pipe size with the appropriate weight. So this is unstandard sizing, which states the nominal dimension of pipe. Take note that nominal, use of nominal dimension of pipe. So iron pipe size. So the next section, section 3 of the chapter 14, use of copper tubing. So it is allowed in the pump plumbing system to use copper tubing. Or section 3 of the chapter 14, use of copper tubing. So it is allowed to use copper as a tube material, as it is also allowed to use stainless steel, for example in kitchenwares. We want materials that do not generate stains, materials that do not generate ferric oxide. What is ferric oxide? So in Tagalog, ferric oxide is kalawang. So of course, copper do not create ferric oxide because it is not iron. But it is not for the purpose of carrying chemicals or industrial waste. No? So you'll notice, for example, air conditioning system, inside that, there are several copper pipings. But that is specifically used for refrigerant. So there are refrigerant there, and it is allowed to use copper. And also, they are susceptible for ferric oxide because what? Moist condition. There is a susceptibility to rusting. So that's why they are using copper. In the same manner, the plumbing system can use copper tubing. So take note of the word tube versus the word pipe. What is the difference? Okay. So we will learn what is the difference in this course. If we use the word tube, it has similarity but also have difference. Okay. We'll talk about this on the definition chapter 2. Okay. Copper piping has an advantage of for water supply piping. Okay. In addition to the required incised marking, all hand-drawn copper tubing shall be hand-drawn. What is hand-drawn? Hand-drawn copper tubing shall be marked by means of continuous and indelibly colored stripe at least 6.4 mm. Take note, 6.4 mm marking. Very specific. Okay. Well, that is one way to detect peak. It is what? Specifically identified as at least 6.4 mm width and of type K, green, type L, blue, type M, red, type DWB, yellow. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 types: type K, L, M, and DWB. So DWB is colored yellow. Type K is colored green. Type L is blue. Type M is red. So yellow meaning waste. So do not drink on that piping or tubing because it is purely waste. Untreated waste product. Okay? Copper tubing of flexible quality. Flexible copper tubing. So there are copper tubing that can be easily, but inside the air conditioning, there are copper tubing that is but coiled. So it can be flexible enough. Why? Those are intentionally being coiled because of the vibration. Take note, if you touch the air conditioning, you can feel the vibration. In order for the tubing or the pipe to be safe, meaning not to be what? To be easily damaged. So, because damaging pipe will what? Give us leakage, problematic leakage. So in order to avoid that, that is intentionally being coiled. Okay? So the next section, number 4 of this same chapter, is lead material, because what we are talking about quality and material, planning material. So copper, now lead. What is lead?